Hello YouTube, studio construction update. Yes, we're done with the floor. I did 16 time of sanding with the bath sander with a really big heavy machine. So I did 8 time with the 18 grid belts, and then again 8 time with the 120 grid belts. So I did like this 3 times, like this 3 times, and then twice in a long way. But now look at this finish. I think it's absolutely beautiful. And yes, on the end I choose the Osmo hard wax, not this cheap swing color parquet lac. This is how they call it. Because I find some really weird data on a technical description. The full dry time, which is defined like what's the next time when you can apply on it carpet. So this time, what the fuck you want to sell to me? So this is why I chose on the end the Osmo hard wax, which is some kind of special release for the Holz Possling shop here in Germany. They called it, what's the name? It's Holzwerker Hartwax, something like this. So it's exactly the same like Osmo, just a really bit cheaper because of the other branding. So this one, the Hartwax, is really dried really fast. So the first layer I did on the morning, and the second layer I already can do on around noon or 2 o'clock afternoon, something like this. And then after 2 days, this hard wax is absolutely dried out, so we can come over it and we can continue the small works what we still have here in the studio. So what we did after the lacking, we installed a few connectors. And what is left is only the places where is double connector with the Ethernet connection, mostly. The reason for that, we did here a mistake with this hose. So the mistake is on the time when we cut the hole, I didn't choose what kind of connectors we came here. And now what I have connectors is not fitting only the distance. Of course, the diameter is it's exactly everywhere. It's the same, so it doesn't matter what kind of brand you choose from the connectors. But the distance, unfortunately, this depend on the model, what you choose. And what I choose, it's really simple. We have from that kind a lot from some kind of demolishing, so including Ethernet connectors. So on the end, I didn't have to spend zero euro on my main outlets and also on my Ethernet connections. Here, my plan, we will do some kind of small woodwork. So I will do some kind of wood frame, and then inside into these wood plates, this is where we will install the connectors. And we finished almost. We finished with the base straps. I told you guys in the last video we will do the base straps by ourselves because of the price of the base straps, what I find on the market. So on the market they said every 4 meter is 100 euro. So on the end I arrived to about 800 euro just for the base straps. So I decide no, and this is why we did by ourselves. I think this base strap is absolutely looks nice, and the dimensions, the front face here, it's about 28 centimeter, and it's 23 or 24 centimeter deep. But under the base strap we kept this very small 45 degree mirror, acoustic mirror system. So on the end I'm quite happy with the results. Maybe you can hear already. So without any kind of carpet and any kind of other acoustic treatment, this place already, it's well controlled. Maybe here you can see the corner. So this is how we will finish. I think I still have a work on that corner a bit. Today I just closed this one and I did really small touches on these bass traps. And here I also have to close this corner. So on my computer it looks absolutely amazing. Every corner is matching and every corner is meet each other. But I forgot something. I forgot these really heavy steel elements on my ceiling. So unfortunately, yeah, the bass traps cannot meet on the corner. So yeah, this is what's happened when you as a designer, you forgot the reality. So not everything is the same like how you see on your computer monitor. So here I have to do some kind of woodwork to close these bass traps. And tomorrow the carpet is coming. And one of my friends, he asked me when he saw this really nice floor with this heart wax, he told me, wow, this is beautiful. And he wants me to do his home also with this heart wax. And then he asked me, so what's your plan with that? And I told him, yeah, now on Monday, the carpet will come on it. And then he asked, what? Are you crazy? So why you did the waxing and all this sanding process and whatever? But he forgot something. This wood is new and fresh. And if you don't apply nothing on a fresh wood, I can take a bet your wood floor will be cracked or will be distorted or whatever, because the fresh wood is releasing the moisture slowly, and it's make a lot of defect on your wood surface. So you must need to close at least the top surface, or how I did, like sanding and oil, then wax, then sanding back, and then again wax. So this is the minimum what you have to do with fresh wood floors. So on the next week, we will install the lamp system, we will install the carpet, we will install the wood lines to the corners, and I will finish the bass trap works, and what we have more, switches, whatever, really small touches. But unfortunately, no, you know guys, it's Christmas time, so now all the workers is in holiday, and I just have two guys who can help me, but not all the day again. So I will be really busy with the final construction of my new studio. And then I hope 2 weeks later we can start to move up the things to the studio. And here I have to buy some kind of really big sofa system. Maybe I will do for you guys a video what kind of sound system I choose. Because of this new stupid Dolby Atmos craziness. So I'm really interested on it. I checked the Dolby Atmos systems, and I saw one movie with the proper Dolby Atmos sound system, and wow, this is what I want. So here, I think 2 weeks later, I will do here the screen for the projector, and I will install the projector to that place, and my new Xbox, and the new amplifiers, and the new speakers, whatever. But let me prepare myself for tomorrow for the carpet job, because guys, this is 18 meter long, and yeah, this will be a really big job. And I also finished this top surface of this parapet wall. I find this wood in a garbage and I clean it down. It's full with concrete and nails and whatever, but now it looks absolutely beautiful. So I did everything with hands, so with hand planers, hand sanding, and this is really, really a nice piece of wood now. And one of my friends, he immediately jumped to me. He wanted the same in his kitchen, so. What you see here, this is my old new acoustic diffusers, which came to the wall and also onto the ceiling in different areas in the studios. In the past, a lot of guys on our YouTube, they complained about, why you not close these acoustic panels and, you know, this glass fiber will come out. And they forgot something. In that time, those panels here is in experimental state, let's say like this, because the development of these panels is took from me like almost 1.5 years to finalize the right thickness and the right sound absorption and whatever, and also the inside construction, how it's built. So now it's finished, so now all the panel is done. I have from that 18 pieces. Under the black textile, we applied the same white acoustic, really thick textile, and this is how we closed the front surface. And also on a back surface, we did the same, minus the black textile, of course. And now this just waiting for the final touch, which is this very special profile that I did for these panels. So on the end, this will be installed like this. It's just a piece what is remained from the cuts. But here on the side, you can see how it's built. So this edge is evenly just touching the black textile with extra 1 millimeter, just to push down just a little bit. And here I have a tiny bit of air, or I don't know how it's called this. So it's like 5 millimeter of wood section, which has helped me to close the box itself, make sure the dust and this glass fiber materials cannot escape from the box itself. And it's also having a bit on acoustics, so the sound cannot escape and cannot go in from the side. So in overall, now it's about 97 centimeter height and 63 centimeter width, the black area where is the sound can go in. And I have an idea with these black panels. On the end, I want to make some kind of graphic on it, and I already have an idea what I will do with this black textile. Let's say I'm quite good on hand drawing and on hand painting. I didn't choose yet the method, how I will paint it or how I will draw it, but I have a really cool idea what I will do with those panels. I hope you guys enjoyed. See you next time. Bye. The first audio gear in the studio. I find this in a garbage, of course, and I really like it. It's already fallen on 3 times from here to down there, and it survived. Maybe just one pot meter is, the main switch is gone, but all the rest is still working. I think I have here some crappy noisy, but maybe this will stay here, because somehow this is matching with this place, no?